Julián Castro will be making a very important announcement leading up to the 2020 presidential bid. We've already seen from his brother, his identical twin brother, Joaquin Castro, and apparently his mom, Maria Rosie Castro. It was also, you know, part of the planned introductions to him. Julián was a former San Antonio mayor. His mom was also very politically active and also once ran for mayor. And here now is Julián Castro. Let's listen in.
Buenos días. First of all, I want to say a big thank you to my mom. I bet there are a lot of y'all that may have come here to see her instead of me. You know, my mom grew up on this west side of San Antonio, and she got involved in politics a long time ago because she wanted to improve her community here on the west side to make sure that folks had basic things like streets and drainage. And so she got active back then in the Young Democrats. And then she ran when she was 23 years old with this slate called the Committee for Barrio Betterment. And their slogan was, give government back to the people. Back then, as y'all remember, they didn't have single-member districts, so very few women and people of color ever got elected. All of that slate of the Committee for Barrio Betterment lost in April of 1971. But on election night, one of the local reporters asked her how she felt. She felt that she felt good about what they had done and that they'd be back. Well, Mom, I think we're back. You know, so many journeys for me and for my family have started right here. And today we begin another one. In this journey, I am so lucky to have an incredible partner in my wife, Erica. And a wonderful inspiration in our daughter, whom many of y'all know, Karina. And in our little one, Christian. So I want to thank each and every one of you as well for being here today and joining us. What a great crowd we got out here. I also want to take a moment to say thank you to the press who are here. You know, there was a time when Joaquin and I thought we were going to go into journalism. And so I know that the press work hard and that they are the friend of the truth in this country. Thank you very much for being here. So this is a special place for all of us, this west side of San Antonio. This is the place where my grandmother Victoria came in 1922. When she immigrated from Mexico as a 7-year-old orphan. It's where she grew up, where she worked hard for years as a maid, a cook, and a babysitter while raising my mom as a single parent. It's where my mother became an activist, working to improve the quality of life for her own community. It's where my brother, Joaquin, and I were raised by my mom, where we went to school. We were baptized just over there at the Guadalupe Church. We got a great public school education just a few blocks away, and I had the honor of serving these neighborhoods as mayor of San Antonio for 5 years. Y'all, this morning, I rode the number 68 bus with my brother down Guadalupe Street, like we did so many times when we were kids. Only this time, I brought my daughter Karina with me. That was the same route that we used to take with my mother to get to school or to go to her work during the summer. I want y'all to look around this neighborhood. There are no front runners that are born here, but I've always believed that with big dreams and hard work, anything is possible in this country. This community is a community like so many others across the nation, a community of good people, of humble people, people who go to work early and stay late, oftentimes at more than one job, so they can provide for their family. When they go to bed at night, they say hopeful prayers. They want their children to do well. They want good health. They want the dignity that comes from a good job and the peace of mind that comes from being able to retire on their own terms. This is a community built by immigrants. Families from Mexico, but also families from Germany and from other countries. It's a community also built by Native Americans. Yeah! Families who worked to build a future. Folks who came here to serve our country at Fort Sam Houston and Lackland and Randolph Air Force Base. And today, this community represents America's future. Diverse, fast-growing, optimistic, a place where people of different backgrounds have come together to create something truly special. And I'm proud to call myself a son of San Antonio. You know, 6 years ago, I had the honor of standing before the Democratic National Convention. I said then that the American dream is not a sprint or even a marathon, but a relay. My story wouldn't be possible without the strong women who came before me and passed me the baton. Because of their hard work, I have the opportunity to stand in front of you today. My family story wouldn't be possible without a country that challenged itself to live up to the promise of America. That was the point of the American dream. It wasn't supposed to be just a dream. America was a place where dreams could become real. But the thing is that right now, the relay isn't working. Today, we're falling backwards instead of moving forward. And the opportunities that made America the America that we love, those opportunities are reaching fewer and fewer people. Today, we're at risk of dropping that baton. And that's why we're all here this morning, because we're going to make sure that the promise of America is available to everyone in this 21st century. You see, I learned from my mother so many years ago in this community that when we want change, we don't wait for change, we work for it. When my grandmother got here almost 100 years ago, I'm sure that she never could have imagined that just two generations later, one of her grandsons would be serving as a member of the United States Congress, and the other would be standing with you here today to say these words: I am a candidate for President of the United States of America. Thank you.